Hi, this is Russ Andersson with an introduction to SynthEyes tracking. I'm going to start out opening up my shot. And it's a full 1920 by 1080p shot. And I'm going to run the auto tracker. And it's going to go through and analyze it to figure out exactly where the 2D features are throughout the duration of the shot. Right now this is running on a Core 2 Duo machine, not that big of a machine. And had this been running on a 8-core machine, for example, it'd be going about 4 times faster, and we'd have been long done by now. But instead, you get to listen to me chat for a little bit. So this is the site over to the right where there was talk of putting a Phillies baseball stadium. And we're going to see what we can do about adding that in these days now. In this kind of a shot, the thing that we need to look for are moving vehicles, and also perhaps some repeated texture problems on the buildings where it could sometimes skip from one identical window to another, for example. But here we have that one particularly obvious car. We'll delete that, and now we'll go ahead and do the 3D solve of the shot. And SynthEyes is going and analyzing exactly where the camera went and where all the trackers are in a full 3D space. And now that we've done that, we can have it go and look for any trackers that might have had any problems. And it's found a couple that aren't so good, so we'll just fix them by deleting them and go back and resolve the shot. You notice the error is about 1 pixel here to start out with. And now it just dropped down to about 4/10 of a pixel. So we've improved the track substantially by deleting those two particularly bad points. So now we can start looking at a coordinate system setup. And we're going to add something down in this area of the shot. So it's important to use trackers in that particular location as a basis for the coordinate system. And there are two here that are at the ground level that are pretty good. There's not really a third one that's quite at the ground level. So I'm going to do a little quick supervised track and drop one in on a little feature in the back that is also roughly ground level. And once I hit the right button, we'll just track through that. And that'll be the third point in our coordinate system in just a second. So it's running and doing a rough track on that at the moment. And I'm going to go and lock it up and switch over to the coordinate system panel. So this first point is going to be my origin. This point is going to be along the x-axis. And this third point is going to be somewhere along the ground plane as well. And it goes and readjusts everything to match that particular specification. So now I can go and add in my initial little building, say, or stadium perhaps, and spin that around in some particular orientation. And now I have my initial insert. And when you're doing this, you need to look carefully at things that are right around the edge of where you're inserting to watch out for sliding sorts of problems. And typically you do want to have a number of trackers right along that boundary, because by putting trackers at those locations and using them for reference as you're inserting whatever your object is or doing whatever your effect is, you avoid having any sliding at those particular locations. And you know, very often the ground is not exactly flat, and you know, surfaces are irregular, not exactly square, or whatever. So you actually always want to use some image-based reference to position things. So at this point, I could go and render out a little test insert movie that would be nicely anti-aliased so you could see how smooth it is. Or I would go and export any of the large number of different packages instead. And here you're seeing about 2/3 of the this list. So I hope that gives you some idea what SynthEyes is about. There are a lot more tutorials to look at and the manual. And of course, you know, try the demo version out yourself. There's a lot to learn, and I wish you luck, and thanks for watching.